You are now about to experience the source of real enlightenment.
My name is Jesus Medina. I'm the creator of KO Method, which is a holistic approach to fitness and self-defense training. I'm also the owner of Sea Breeze Fitness, which is located in Costa Mesa, California, which is why we're not recording this. Today I'm going to go ahead and share with you guys my prediction for the Canelo versus Lara fight. Believe it or not, I think this fight is going to end in a draw. Alright, yes, I said in a draw, alright. I will tell you this much though, I know Lara will not win this fight, unfortunately. I actually want Lara to win. I'm Mexican, full-blooded Mexican. I don't take sides just because of race or blood or whatnot. Forget that, alright? Boxing is boxing, martial arts is martial arts, strategy is strategy. I'm neutral about it. So, Lara, magnificent fighter, magnificent on his feet. Obviously fast speed. But you guys are gonna think I'm crazy for this. He's a one-dimensional fighter. What I mean by that is all his points, all again points. All right, not really. I mean, he has power, but all his points all hit in the midline of his opponents. They never come from the side, stuff like that. Especially no body shots. All right. The only other thing he has aside from his straight left, is his jab. Decent jab, and then other than that is an uppercut that he hardly ever uses. Now, when he does use it, at least 50% of the time, maybe a little less, 43% of the time, he contacts that uppercut, and he contacts it devastating. Lara needs to rely on that uppercut that he hardly ever brings out, right? He can set it up easily with that lead hand left. Setting that up so that he can set up that uppercut, right? So lead hand left, jab, then uppercut, alright? It will land on Canelo if he throws it. We'll see if he does or not. Now let's go to Canelo. He has a magnificent right straight, but he hardly ever uses it. Nowhere near as much as he should. And he never uses his jab very much, alright? He knows how to use it, but he just decides not to use it. He goes more for that counter-punching style. He does that very well, and he connects. A lot of high volume punching, not extremely high, but a lot higher than what Lara's gonna be, alright? And he's very accurate with those punches, alright? And he's very crafty, I mean, he comes from all kinds of angles, alright? So, that straight right is going to contact a lot, believe it or not, a Lara. And it's gonna create enough of a distraction, maybe not damage, but enough of a distraction to sneak in or just blatantly give him that left hooks. Right, that Canelo does very well to the body of Lara. When it came to Angulo versus Lara, Angulo landed by the seventh round, he had already landed 64 shots, body shots, opposed to only four from Lara. Right, that's a huge difference. And I mean, you guys know how Lara hit the ground twice because of those setups that those low blows created. Canelo can simply slip to his right. He's an orthodox boxer already. Most orthodox boxers like to side crunch to the right. That's what's gonna help him a lot against Lara. Again, remember I said Lara shoots down the middle a lot. So he's not very good shooting towards his left. Obviously he still contacts and stuff like that, but you don't wanna do this number, right? Shoot towards the left as a lefty. Why? Because you're opening yourself all this up to that lefty, and it's less accurate. It's taking the distance away from you if you're trying to shoot that way. And again, he does contact, but not against Canelo. He's not gonna do it. The point is Canelo needs to go to his right to eliminate that straight left that's coming from Lara, and then follow up with that nice straight right that he has, and then give some uppercuts. I have a feeling that Canelo will eliminate that straight left, especially that jab. But obviously Lara's Lara, he knows how to control distance very, very wisely with his feet. That's why he's so quick with it. All right, so that's one thing Canelo needs to worry about, stay away from. Obviously that straight left that Lara has and that uppercut that he hardly ever uses. This is, each other are gonna cancel each other out, all right, on certain things that they're good at. That's what's gonna make an interesting fight, and that's what's gonna make it go all 12 rounds. And this one, I guarantee you, Canelo's not gonna choose to go 12 rounds. It's gonna happen. So it's going to be a very interesting fight, I'm hoping that it's going to be action-packed, because a lot of, he might move around a little too much and might not show enough action. But obviously when the exchanges do happen, oh, it's going to be a nice, nice counter-punching clinic for all you boxing enthusiasts, boxers or martial artists or strategists, alright? So once again, It's gonna end in a draw, and if not, obviously Canelo's gonna win it on decision. And like I said, I want Lara to win, but we'll see what happens, all right? Once again, this is my breakdown. Not even a breakdown, it's just my quick prediction. My name is Jesus Medina. I'm the creator of KO Method, which is a holistic approach to fitness and self-defense training. I'm also the owner of Sea Breeze Fitness. We're located in Costa Mesa, California, which is right when I'm recording this. I just want to remind you, man, we're only limited to our creativity. So pain is temporary, pride is eternal. Fulfillment lasts forever. Don't let the inner demons get to you, right? Use your creativity to beat them and fight, fight, fight. The fight will be worth it. KO Method, baby, knocking out the competition.